Hello, everybody. May the good Lord bless you and guide you and protect you all the days of your life in the land of the living, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Our topic today is breaking the spirit of poverty. Breaking the spirit of poverty. Having a relationship with Jesus certainly doesn't mean we'll be free of problems or struggles. Life can be tough, and even as Christians, we will face many challenges. Before we were saved, we were no threat to the devil, but when we accepted Jesus into our heart, something changed. We took up a new residence in the spiritual battlefield and immediately became an enemy of Satan. Many of our battles, struggles, and trials in life are rooted in the spiritual realm. As a result, war must be waged on the spiritual battlefield and fought with spiritual weapons. Overcoming poverty is one example of this principle. Jesus taught us that the devil is a thief who comes to steal and destroy God's blessings in our life. John 10:10. Many Christians unnecessarily suffer financial lack simply because they don't understand the nature of this spiritual battle they are in. Your Father's blessings. God is a good God. Our Heavenly Father wants to bless us, and He will never send us into battle unequipped. He has given us His word as the sword of the Spirit to overcome the lies of the enemy. The book of Ephesians 6:17, you can read it. Something happens when we put the scripture in our heart and mouth and begin to point them out at the enemy. Remember, victory over poverty is already yours. Through His death on the cross and His resurrection, Jesus has destroyed all the works of the devil. 1 John 3:8. But now He calls on you to enforce that victory by declaring His promises over your life. Apostle Paul wrote that the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. 2 Corinthians 10:3-4. Through the truth of God's word, you have been given dominion over financial lack and every other stronghold in your life. So go ahead and let the enemy know he no longer has permission to harass you. Scripture tells us that the devil is the father of lies. John 8:44. Many Christians have believed the lie that God wants them to experience lack instead of abundance. Yet, God wants to replace the lie with the truth that He wants you to prosper and be in good health. John 3:1-2. If you are a child of God, the devil has no rights in your life, but you must move into an offensive position and take back anything the enemy has stolen. Boldly speak to your circumstances, reminding them that you are a child of the King and a joint heir with Christ. Your words create your realities, so make sure they line up with God's word. Don't stop pressing in until you experience the victory you have been promised. Make sure you are taking steps of faith, sowing financial seeds in anticipation of God's abundant harvest in your life. In Jesus' name, you have power over the devil. But He is not going to give up without a fight. You must realize the authority God has given you and lay an axe to the roots of poverty and financial lack. May God awaken the mighty warrior inside of you so you can pull down strongholds in your own life and then go to battle on behalf of your loved ones. So do not be lazy in things of God. Please do not be lazy, because poverty is an attitude of the heart. It comes from within. It is a development of heart that comes from the response we make to the difficulties in our lives. Two people can go through the same experiences and suffer the same conditions of life, and yet come out entirely different. One can succumb to those problems and become moody and bitter. But the other one can rejoice. The other can come through these experiences and be a successful person, happy and generous person. It is not what happens to you that matters, but what you do with what happens to you. Please, I would like you to pray this prayer point against spirit of poverty, against spirit of stagnation, in Jesus' name. I set myself free from bondage to failure, sickness, poverty, untimely death, lack and failure at the age of success, in Jesus' name. Every power tying me down to one spot, perish in the name of Jesus Christ. I break every curse pronounced against my destiny in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Because prayer can move mountains. Every mountain on my way to success and victory, be removed in Jesus' name. I destroy by fire every boundary the enemy has marked down for me in Jesus' name. And I break self-imposed stagnation and poverty limitation in the name of Jesus. I receive double portion of blessings in exchange for my shame and delay in Jesus' name. Every cause that I have brought into my life through disobedience and ignorance, break by fire. Break by fire in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. And again you pray, every evil machinery against my prosperity be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I destroy by fire every weapon of poverty targeted against my life in the name of Jesus. Every descendant of poverty in my life, fall down and die. Fall down and die in the name of Jesus. Every evil power sitting on my prosperity, so must assault and die in the name of Jesus. Every remote control mechanism fashioned against my destiny be consumed by fire in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen.